With doubtnet, get instant video solutions to all your maths, physics, chemistry and biology doubts. Just click the image of the question, crop the question and get instant video solution. Download doubtnet app today.
Hi everyone, let's take a question. So here the question is, we have the matching, okay? And the first one is our alpha D glucopyranose and beta D glucopyranose. So this is when we have these structures in the open chain representation. So these are our alpha D glucose and beta D glucose, okay? But when we have the structure like this, okay, let's see the structure. So here we have is the structure that is this one. C double bond O, here we have H. H O H, here we have is O H, and here we have H H O H, here we have is H and O H, okay, and here we have C H 2 O H, okay, here we have C H 2 O H, okay. So here what happens is this bond is connected to this position, okay, and then we have the formation of the cyclic compounds. Okay, then we have the formation of the cyclic compounds like this. Here we have O, okay, and here also we have the O. Okay, but when we represent this, here we have CH2OH, here we have H, here we have H, here we have OH, here we have OH, H, HOH, and here we have is HOH. This is first position, okay, and this is the alpha form. This is alpha. Okay, and in the beta form, the difference is that here we will have OH, H, H, OH. Okay, here we have is OH, H. Just the difference is in the first carbon. Difference is in the first carbon, CH2OH. Here we have is H. Okay, this is the beta. So here, this structure is formed by this transfer. Okay, by this transfer. So this is our tautomerization. Okay, and it also represents the mutarotation. Mutarotation is the specific change in the rotation. For this, we have the rotation that is plus 110. Here we have is plus 52.5. And here we have is the plus 19.7. So, mutarotation is that when we have the change in the specific rotation. Okay, and we have the equilibrium value that is this one. Okay, so it means that here our... For the A option, we have the correct one is Q and R. Okay, so here we can write for A, we have the Q and R. The next is our glucose and mannose. Next is glucose and mannose. Okay, if we talk about the glucose and the mannose structure. Okay, if we talk about the structure of the glucose and the mannose, then these two are our apimers. These two are our apimers. Okay, so here suppose this is our... Here we have H, O, H, here we have is O, H, here we have H, okay, and here we have is the same, the structure is same like the glucose only, okay, just the difference is that it varies at one carbon in the configuration, okay, so here we have H, O, H, here we have is H, O, H, and here we have CH2OH. Okay, so if we now draw the structure for the mannose, so for the mannose we have the structure like this. Here we have this, here we have is HOH, okay, here we have HOH, CH2OH, here we have is H OH, here we have HOH. So if we see that here the difference is at the second carbon, okay, the difference is at the second carbon, this is, these are our apimers, these are our apimers, okay, so these are those pair of the diastereomers that differ in the configuration about a single carbon atom. So it means that for the B option, okay, for the B option we have the term that is apimerization. Okay, and here we also have this transformation that is the Lobry-De Bruijn. If we see this transformation, so in this transformation what we have is here we have CH double bond O, here we have COH, H, and here we will have the similar structure. Okay, this is for the glucose. The difference will be occur at the 1 and 2 carbon only. Here we have CHOH, here we have COH. Okay, and here we have this. Here this is our enol form. Okay, now from this enol form, we have the formation of CH2OH, C double bond O here. This is our fructose. This is our fructose. The whole structure remains same. Now another here we will have the formation, that is HOCH double bond. Sorry, here we have the C. Here we have the C and here we have is OH. This is enol. Okay, this is enol. And from this we have another transformation, that is CH double bond O, CHOH. So this is our mannose. This is our mannose. Okay, it means that here this is this whole mechanism. Okay, this whole mechanism is our that Lobry-De-Bruijn Van Eckenstein rearrangement. Van Eckenstein rearrangement. Rearrangement. Okay, so this is the Lobry-De-Bruijn and this occurs to the 1,2 enolization. 1,2 enolization reaction. Okay, so it means that here if we see the options, okay, here if we see for the B, we can say S and P. Now the C is fructose to glucose and we have already seen that that is formed in the Lobry-De-Bruijn, okay, that doesn't represent the apimer. So for the C, we will have P and the last one, okay, the last one here, we can clearly see that here we have this our aldehyde group, right, and here we are having the, here this is keto group. Right, C double bond O, this is representing the tautomerization. Okay, it is representing this form. Here if we see, it is representing the this form that we have shown in the Lobry-De-Bruijn, okay, reaction. Sorry, let's see here. Okay, this is representing the this form. It is representing the this form. Okay, so here we can say that here it is representing the, for the D, we have the representation P and R, okay, because it takes place through the 1,2 enolization, okay, and here we are having the conversion. Here we are having the conversion. Conversion at which part? When we have the keto to enol conversion, right? This is our keto form, fructose is our keto, and we have the enol, so that is, then we have the tautomerization. Then we have the tautomerization, but not from fructose to glucose, but when we have from fructose to mannose, okay. So here we have for the D, P and R. Okay, so these are our required answers. These are our required answers for this matching. Thank you.
For class 6 to 12, ITJ and NEET level. Trusted by more than 5 crore students. Download Doubt and App today.